Chesterfields are on the move with something smokers all approve. Mildness plus no aftertaste, no unpleasant aftertaste.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Try a pack of Chesterfields and do it
today.
Someone waits for me.
This is Ken Carpenter. Welcome you to the Bing Crosby Show for Chesterfield. Produced and transcribed in Hollywood with John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Jed Collins with the Bears and Bing's guests, Jimmy Stewart and Toni Arden. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for our first broadcast in December, we present Chesterfield's Santa Claus, the one with a cellophane pack, Bing Crosby.
Hey, Ken, I must compliment you on the very adroit way that you got in the product mention there. Okay. Golly, I wish you hadn't brought Christmas up, though.
What?
It's such a problem, Ken, trying to get gifts for people that they can use.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you one thing, Bing. You won't have any trouble thinking of a gift for Bob Hope this year.
I should say I won't. I've already mailed him his carton of Chesterfields.
The reason you won't have any trouble getting Bob a present this year is because he's completely remodeling his house.
Yes, and it's high time, too, I think. Big movie star like him with a big Clabber Girl baking powder sign painted clear across the front of it. He must be kidding, isn't he? You mean he's digging up money to remodel his joint that costs a lot of loot?
Bing, I drove by Bob's house the other day, and the whole place is torn up.
Well, that could be just a scheme of his to get his relatives out on the street. Once you got them out, they're out.
Bob is really excited about this new manse. And he's looking for a real fancy name to hang on the sign over his front gate.
Oh, how about Blubbering Heights?
You think no, no, I think it should be something more really romantic and dignified, descriptive, like Rolling Meadows or Hope Hall.
Monologue Manse.
Chesterfield Cottage.
Ah, yes. Oh, I got a great name for Hope's house.
What's that?
How about Offensive Manor? That's an effort, you know.
Bing,
just
I just don't think that's quite it.
No. Well, you worry about it, Ken. I got to worry about the opening tune here.
That's worry?
It's going to be worry for the audience. I'm set.
Over a bottle of wine, under a tropical sky, a typical tropical atmosphere, all his heart could hear was a sigh. Over a bottle of wine, playing the tropical game, a typical tropical love affair, oh, that tropic air was to blame. They knew it was foolish to resist, and so they kissed, never dreaming of tomorrow. Over a bottle of wine, living the tropical life, proving how happy a man could be when he's on a spree with his wife.
A typical tropical atmosphere, all his heart could hear was a sigh.
Over a bottle of wine,
rendezvous, playing the tropical game for two. A typical tropical love affair, all the tropic air was to blame.
They knew it was foolish to resist, and so they kissed, never dreaming of tomorrow. Over a bottle of wine, living the tropical life, proving how happy a man could be when he's on a spree with his wife. a living a tropical, typical, tropical life.
Mucho gusto, con enchiladas y tacos.
Folks, you know, with Christmas coming up fast, I want to tell you about a wonderful guy who can solve maybe 90% of your shopping problems. He's your neighborhood Chesterfield dealer, and he carries a complete line of gifts for you and for your family. So drop in to see him. And while you're there, get a load of your dealer's display of Chesterfield Christmas card cartons. You know, that's the carton that combines your gift and your greeting in one.
The carton is your greeting card, and inside is your present, Chesterfield's. And that's the perfect present for any smoker. Because Chesterfield gives smokers something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness, plus no unpleasant aftertaste.
So this Christmas, when you send your holiday greetings, send them by carton. Bright Christmas card cartons of Chesterfield.
At Christmas time and all the year, it's Chesterfield that brings good cheer with mildness and a better taste. And no one plays an aftertaste. Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
A Christmas card carton of milder Chesterfield.
That's right.
Domino, Domino, you're an angel that heaven has sent me. Domino, Domino, you're a devil designed to torment me. When your heart must know that I love you so, tell me why, tell me why. Why do you make me cry, Domino? Just one look in your eyes and I melt with desire. Just a touch of your hands and I burst into fire. And my whole world fills with music when I'm lost in your embrace. But I know that you're fickle and I'm not misled. Each attractive new face that you see turns your head. And it scares me that tomorrow someone else may take my place. Domino, Domino, won't you tell me you never desert me? Domino, Domino, if you stay, I don't care how you hurt me. Fate has made you so. You can't change, I know. You can't change, though you try. But then neither can I, Domino. Domino, Domino, nothing matters if I have you.
Nice out on some more.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present here a charming lady who is one of the most talented young vocalists, I believe, that's come along in the popular field in many, many years. I want you to meet Miss Toni Arden.
Uh-huh.
Toni, how about doing a number for the folks here?
Why, sure. What would you like to have me sing?
Well, I heard your new recording, that song called Once.
Mm-hmm.
Would you do that?
I'd love to.
John, assist this delightful lady with it.
Sings like a bird. That was nice, Toni. Really nice.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to present an old friend of mine, that very fine actor, Mr. Jimmy Stewart.
Thank you. Thank you, Bing.
Well, Jim, how are Gloria and how are the twins?
Oh, they're just fine, Bing. They're just fine. I'm a wreck.
What's wrong?
Well, Bing, you remember a couple of weeks ago, you went Christmas shopping with me and we bought Gloria a present.
Remember it? I'm glad that's over.
But it isn't. We got to go again.
Not we, old boy. I took you to that little French dress shop next door and I helped you select a beautiful petticoat. What's
Yeah, but I found out that Gloria has one exactly like it.
You sure, Jimmy?
I'm absolutely sure. Yes, the other morning I was peeking in the window. The other morning, I was peeking in the window of the Bendix.
Oh, of the Bendix.
And I... there it was.
Wow.
Well, just spinning around there, the same darn petticoat.
This is a blow. It's tough luck, Jim. But I tell you, all you got to do is just take the petticoat, you go back to Fifi's lingerie shop, and you exchange it for something else.
Yeah, that's just what I've been trying to do ever since 9 o'clock this morning.
Since 9 o'clock this morning?
Yeah, every time I start into Fifi's place, I lose my nerve and wind up in the drugstore next door.
Jimmy, you've got to get a hold of yourself.
So far today, I've had 12 cups of Ovaltine and 6 bacon and tomato sandwiches. I was spoken to twice for loitering in the magazine counter.
That's funny. I was in the drugstore earlier today. Funny I didn't see you.
Yeah, well, that might have been when the woman was demonstrating the mud pack on me.
Oh, what you won't go through the stall. I noticed you were carrying a lot of bundles when you walked in here tonight, too.
Yeah, well, one of those packages is the petticoat, and the rest of the stuff I picked up in the drugstore.
You get any bargains?
Yes. I got a nice alarm clock and a canasta shuffler.
Oh, I must get one of those.
A mahjong set.
Mahjong set, huh?
Yes, half a bushel of assorted nuts.
Hey, Jim, your Christmas shopping's about done.
You know, Bing, I just think this whole mess I'm in is, it's just fate.
What are you getting at?
Well, you know, when we talked about the gift originally, yeah, my whole idea was to get Gloria something that was daring, something intimate, you mm-hmm. know. Well, the petticoat, the petticoat just doesn't cut the buck.
Well, Jim, come on, wait a minute. Plenty of daring stuff over there in Fifi's shop. You had your chance.
Same thing happened last year. Last year I was going to get Gloria a sweater.
A sweater?
Mm-hmm. Last minute it got cold feet.
What happened?
I gave her yarn and knitting needles.
I bet she's been needling you all year too, huh?
Now this year it's going to be different.
What are you going to do?
Well, when Gloria opens her present for Christmas this year, she's going to get the shock of her life.
Now, wait a minute.
No, sir.
I'm
through with this old-fashioned stuff. I'm going to take the bull by the horn.
Atta boy, Jim. Now you're working in there, Jim.
I'm going to take this petticoat right over to Fifi's Flores and Flimsy shop, and you're going to exchange it for something bewitching.
I'm in again, huh? Well, off we go. Here, Jim, let me take some of those packages, huh?
Here, you take the petticoat and the canasta shuffler. I can carry the alarm clock and the mahjong set and the assorted nuts.
Okay, well, here's Fifi's place. After you, Jimmy.
Bing, I have an idea, Bing. You go and exchange the petticoat. I got to drop into the drugstore.
Oh, no, you don't.
No, look, there's a sign there, special. Nutcrackers, 59 cents.
Well, you get one later. Here we go again at Fifi's. Now, no stalling this time. You hear me, Jim?
Yeah. Yes, gosh, the minute I get inside here and see all those things hanging around, everything goes black.
There's a lot of black things hanging around.
Golly, what will they think of next?
I don't know, but I hope I'm not with you when they do.
Ah, bonjour, gentlemen. Entrez, s'il vous plaît.
I'll bet this is Fifi.
It sure ain't Barry Fitzgerald, though. Now, no hemming and hawing, Jim. Just tell the lady your problem.
May I help you, gentlemen?
Yes. Yes? I wonder if you could tell us how to get to Knott's Berry Farm.
Have Knott's crackers next door.
We know all about them.
You know, my friend and I were in here a couple weeks ago, and we bought a fancy petticoat.
Oh, and you are back so soon. You are the playboy from Texas, yes?
Oh, heck no. No, you see, I bought a petticoat from a wife, and
Oh, you are married. Oh, that is too bad.
Why is that?
I am not. Oh, but
don't look at me. I'm cooked, too.
Ma, c'est la vie.
Vraiment, vraiment. You see, my friend bought this petticoat here for his wife, and she has one just like it, so he wants to exchange it.
Oh, then perhaps you would like a petticoat like this very chic one I am wearing. Huh? Look at this. Voila!
Oh, my gosh.
Ha, ha, ha.
one care for an English walnut.
There's a hole in that bag, Jim. Hold it up.
No, miss, I don't want you to get the wrong idea about this thing. I'm married, and, well, I thought I might get something more dazzling than a petticoat. So.
Oh, I see. Something intime. Well, step over here. I have so many attractive things. Ooh, la la. Look at these.
Say.
La, they are beautiful. And they come in pale blue, pink, and green.
These aren't bad, Jim. Just grab one. You can't go wrong with these.
And the lace is imported.
Got good rubber in them, too.
But, monsieur...
Yeah, I think I just better get a nice pair of stockings.
Stockings? What kind?
For the legs.
Oh, you make the joke, too.
Jim, listen, you gotta go stronger than stockings. Come on, live.
Oh, I know what you can get for madame. It is called the wraparon.
The chaperon?
Well, you see, it's an oversized towel that's shaped and fitted. I'll slip it on. See, it buttons on in a wink.
Now, what do you use that thing for?
Well, if the phone rings when madame is in the bathtub, she can slip on one of these.
I usually slip on these soap.
Well, here's something else that madame might like. It's the very latest French bathing suit. 2 pieces.
Oh, itsy-bitsy pieces, too.
And look, it folds up and fits into this little gold locket.
Oh, I never. Look at that.
You see, when madame wears this bathing suit, she can also wear the little locket around her neck.
She better wear the locket or she'll get arrested.
Oh, you make another joke.
Joke nothing. I can hear the patrol wagon now.
Would you gentlemen like me to model this bathing suit? I can slip it on if you like.
Come on, shove it back in the locket. Here comes the cops.
I must have hit the button on my alarm clock.
Come on, Jim, now make up your mind. I'm in a rush. I got to get back to work.
Work? Oh, that is the trouble with you American men. All you think about is business. A Frenchman, he says, poof on business, poof on work. A Frenchman says, poof on everything but love. That is why all Frenchmen are so, oh, what is the word?
Poofed? All right, Jim, now what'll it be? There are any number of things here. You made up your mind?
Well, I've been thinking the whole thing over, and I think maybe the thing I ought to get is a nice pair of bloomers.
Blue mail? What is blue mail?
You wouldn't know.
Stop!
Never have you know.
Yes, sir?
But blue mails, I do not understand.
Well, you see... You see, miss, there's something like these things here, only they're about 3 feet longer.
Oh, you mean the slacks.
No. Bloomers. No, they're sort of slip covers for girls.
I don't think you know about bloomers, Fifi. They go back quite a ways.
Look at that girl coming out of the back room.
Holy Toledo.
Oh, that is Mimi, my model. And look, she's wearing the new French bathing suit and the little locket.
Go on, Jim.
Oh, wait for me.
What about the gift for Gloria?
She's going to get
got the Mahjong set.
Until we sound off to Chesterfield, you better give me a hand on this, Jimmy, because we got a real great part for you. Now, I'll tell you when. I'll just bring my hand down just when you
sure,
come
you,
in for
you,
your big...
You
all set? Okay, here we go. Oh, Chesterfields are riding high. I want to tell you the reason why. They're milder with a better taste. And no one plays that aftertaste. Mildness plus.
No aftertaste.
Mildness plus.
No aftertaste.
No one plays that aftertaste in Chesterfield.
That's right.
Wherever you live, whatever you do, there's a Chesterfield dealer near to you. So get in the ball, get in the swing. Just take a tip from Brother Bing and sound off
for Chesterfield.
Sound off
for Chesterfield.
Try a pack of Chesterfields. Do it. Today. Oh, James, you handled that magnificently. Seriously, folks, sound off for Chesterfield and get Chesterfield Mildness Plus No Unpleasant Aftertaste.
Over 1,500 tobacco growers say Chesterfields are milder. And one of the world's most famous industrial research organizations reports Chesterfields leave no unpleasant aftertaste.
So try a pack of Chesterfields and do it today. Here's a new song, at least it's new to me, although I'm notoriously insular when it comes to popular ballads. This is from the new Dean Martin Jerry Lewis picture.
Never before has my heart felt a thrill like this. Never before. Never before. Never before has the whole world stood still like this. As I gaze at the face I simply adore. After today, when they speak about paradise, I'll smile and I'll say, I've been there once or twice. For this is that once in a lifetime, the miracle of your kiss. I've never loved like this, never before. Yes, this is that once in a lifetime, the miracle of your kiss. I've never loved like this, never.
Well, that's the closer for tonight, folks. My thanks to Toni Arden, Jimmy Stewart, and Viola Vaughn for joining in the festivities this evening.
Bing, I'm sorry I got you in all that trouble.
Boy, that was some bathing suit, wasn't it?
Yeah, I only got as far as the locket.
You gotta be quick.
Who's going to be with you next week?
Next week, Jim, we're having Alexis Smith and Bert Wheeler. We're going to do another old television movie. Hope to see you next week, folks. In the meantime, all you got to do is find out that what we tell you about Chesterfield is true. You see your dealer tomorrow and you sound off for Chesterfield.
Bing Crosby Show, presented by Chesterfield, was produced and transcribed in Hollywood by Bill Morrow and Murdo MacKenzie. Tune in next week and hear Bing and his guests, Alexis Smith and Bert Wheeler.